A petition calling for a movie about the Christchurch terror attack to be shut down has attracted more than 55,000 signatures. That number is rising fast. What we know is that the film is set to be called They Are Us, a phrase used by the Prime Minister. We also know that Rose Byrne has been cast in the role of Jacinda Ardern. The PM herself just told Jenny May that was without any consultation with her. But at the centre of this discussion are, or should be, the people who lost the most, the they in that title, those shot, who survived, those lost, the families of those lost, the people for whom those 51 murders weren't a story but were terrible and real. Abdul Fattah Qasem was a loving and beloved husband and father, excited about becoming a grandfather when he was killed at Al Noor Mosque. His daughter Sara Qasem said those extraordinary words at the sentencing of the terrorist, "Let it be known, these tears are not for you." And we're grateful and honoured to have Sara with us again here on Breakfast. Mordena. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome, Sara. Every time you come on Breakfast, we are honoured to have you with us. Thank you.
Thank you so much for having me.
It's our pleasure and our privilege. How did you find out about this film? Who told you about it?
Quite truthfully, and I think this really just adds to the shock of everything, we essentially found out at the very same moment that the public found out about the movie coming out. It was just, you know, a regular day scrolling through social media and having to retake and relook at something a couple of times before it actually registers into your head that, yes, this is true and not just some kind of a hoax or something made up.
And when you registered, what was your response?
Where was the consultation? You know, how could somebody have done something like this and not considered the importance of our sovereignty over our story? And then secondly, the shock at the focus of the movie, which was just completely dismissing and very, very hurtful.
When you spoke at that sentencing, and you spoke extraordinarily well, And there was such power in your work. But I was just reading a lovely write-up of it in Newsroom, and you referred to a thing called kintsugi, a centuries-old Japanese art of fixing broken pottery using powdered gold. You say, your hearts may be broken, but slowly and surely they are reassembling each crack with a thread of gold, becoming stronger and more beautiful and more united than ever before. And I Absolutely. Wondered as I read this, and I remembered you speaking so beautifully, if this is breaking the thread, if this is undoing the thread somewhat.
I mean, I can't say from, I only can speak from my own perspective. I think it's very hard when you speak on behalf of an entire community and it's not very fair. But from my own perspective, it certainly does not undo anything. You know, what we went through, as tragic and horrific as it was, has withstood us with a sense of strength that is pretty unshakable. But I will say that it certainly takes a huge toll and dig at our honour, and particularly with trying to uphold the idea of not reducing our loved ones to numbers. I feel like this just goes completely against that. So it doesn't remove that thread of gold at all, but it's just an injustice.
So you just say, John, if I'm getting this wrong, you just call me on it. I'm looking at your smile now, and I know you will. And also, you are a teacher, right? So you're used to putting naughty boys in their place.
But most certainly.
Good. I want to get this right. Is it the film per se you oppose? Or is it the idea that the hero of the film, the central character in the film, as played Rose Byrne, will be somebody who didn't directly lose anything, the Prime Minister? Now, no one is saying that she didn't do a fantastic job after the Mosque shooting, but there were 51 people murdered and she wasn't related to any of them. Is that the thing you object to most of all, or is it the film per se?
I think it's important first to recognise that we're certainly not dismissing the efforts of the Prime Minister. You know, that is not what this is about at all, because I have come to meet her on multiple occasions now, both on camera and off camera, and I want to acknowledge her response after the attacks. However, this is more just a case of sidelining the victims And, you know, there are still people out there today that have physical implications from the attack, mental implications from the attack. And it just completely plays into this idea of sidelining, to be honest, John, people of color, and the idea of the narrative of, I'm sorry to say, but a white savior. You know, this is our story, and it's still incredibly raw and painful. It hasn't even been a year since the sentencing, not even 1 year. And just simply 2 years from the attack, you know, I personally spent 23 years with my dad and only 2 years without. This is still completely fresh and new. And the idea that somebody is profiting from the trauma and the traumatic grief of my community and myself is just completely inappropriate.
So you are saying, please don't make this film, full stop.
I'm saying, you know, perhaps in the future when you consider the families and you speak with them and you allow a sovereignty over our story, maybe. Right now, with this focus and this lens, absolutely not.
Sara Qasem, you always do your dad, Abdel Fattah, really proud. And you did so again this morning. And we thank
can
you for joining us.
Can I just say one more thing?
Of course.
Sorry,
you can.
John, thank you so much. I really wanted to just take the time to really acknowledge all those people that have been speaking up alongside us and have been sharing and posting and signing a petition that, as you said, is nearly at 50,000 signatures, as well as everybody that has just stood by us for the past 2 years and has really, really acknowledged our hearts and just been incredible, incredible supportive people in our lives.
That's a wonderful note to end on, Sara Qasem. Thank you so much for joining us, as
Thank
always.
You.
We
Thank
really
you.
Appreciate you.